climate change, one of humanity's dilemmas, an issue that faces the surface of our planet Earth. We go on about our lives and let issues fix itself, but what we don't know is that our planet is reaching the boiling point. We are slowly tearing apart our planet, which means we are tearing apart our home. As for whom to blame, we can only blame ourselves. But there's a saying, what problems humanity creates, we shall step forward and repair it. Climate change is already being dealt with by the world, the governments, various communities, and even small local groups.
Well, C-Cubed is DLSL's way of expressing their feelings towards climate change. A group of students and a few teachers have organized a committee where we have made attempts and we're making more attempts to change DLSL's view of climate change and the way that we participate in it.
C-Cubed is the De La Salle School Climate Change Committee, and it's a group of students with a couple of teachers along to help out, and the students have shown great initiative by forming this group.
C-Cubed is a concept which has been introduced by the Environmental Committee of De La Salle in 2009, and its aims are to promote awareness of environmental issues.
I've always been concerned about the environment and the human's way of caring for it, and I was concerned about how our school was facing the environment and the problems with it. So there was an opportunity for me to act, and I joined the C-Cubed along with my friends.
We've been looking at various different options. The first option that we looked at was getting some recycling bins for most of the classrooms. We're also talking about getting wireframe bins to get all those aluminium cans that are thrown into the rubbish into, you know, a separate sort of like wire bin so that we can, you know, take them out and recycle them. We're also looking at grants from the government to get things like water tanks and solar panels and all those other things. We're also looking at maybe for things like National Tree Day, going to Ashfield Park and, you know, getting a few students together to plant some trees.
I thought energy saving light globes for areas at the school which are on timing devices, and also I did think education is the main sort of key to success here, so I thought maybe a class set of picture books that may deal with sort of strategies on how to protect the environment and care for the environment.
Turn off your appliances, turn off the lights that you don't use, be more considerate about what you're actually doing, you know, instead of, you know, just thinking at everything, looking at everything so bluntly, look into something, everything deeper, and, you know, try and evaluate the consequences of what you're doing.
I would use $500 to start growing a vegetable patch. I think the sense of, aside from the environmental benefits, the sense of pride that you would have from growing your own food and then being able to eat it afterwards, or in the case of a school, perhaps selling it and making some money, I think that would be a great sense of achievement. And obviously you're cutting down on transport costs, which in turn help to reduce the fossil fuel usage.